Good day, everybody. Happy Monday. Well, this is it. The last week of instruction. You will have two assignments this week, and I have been honored with the opportunity to present you with your last video lesson of the year. So, we are going to be contrasting, or looking at, Speaking of Courage versus The Charge of the Light Brigade by Lord Alfred Tennyson. Kind of a rinse and repeat of last couple of Monday's assignments with one little twist. The last two assignments have been about themes of protest songs from the same era as the Vietnam War paired with each chapter. This assignment will ask you to juxtapose the idea of valor, courage, and honor as it existed in the Vietnam War, and a war from about 110 to 115 years earlier, the Crimean War between Britain and Russia. The Charge of the Light Brigade is a story about a light cavalry unit that was ordered to charge a cannon position by mistake, and none of the soldiers survived. I like to contrast Norman Bowker's story about not receiving the Silver Star for valor and The Charge of the Light Brigade because it's almost like being able to hear what one of those 600 soldiers who was in the battle and who had charged that position would have said or not been able to say about it, had any of them survived. So let's look at Speaking of Courage. This chapter centers around Norman Bowker's inability to tell anyone about the night in the field with Kyla. He imagines how his dad would react, how an old girlfriend, Sally Kramer / Gustafsson, and even the guy taking his order at the burger place might have reacted. It is obvious he needs to tell someone this story, but he never does. So I'm going to share my screen with you really quickly and point out a few things Norman says and thinks about bravery and courage. All right, the first is about a third of the way through the chapter when he is listing the 7 medals he won as a soldier in Vietnam. Quote, he would have explained to his father that none of these decorations was for uncommon valor. They were for common valor, the routine, daily stuff, just humping, just enduring. But that was worth something, wasn't it? Yes, it was, worth plenty. The ribbons looked good on the uniform in his closet, and if his father were to ask, he would have explained what each signified and how he was proud of all of them, especially the combat infantryman's badge, because it meant he had been there as a real soldier, and had done all the things soldiers do, and therefore, it wasn't such a big deal that he could not bring himself to be uncommonly brave. It's not that he doesn't think he's brave, just that he isn't uncommonly brave enough to get the Silver Star. He was a regular soldier. He did all the stuff a normal soldier would do, but not as much as what a braver soldier could do. The next comes a few pages later, and he's talking about how courage isn't a consistent thing. It changes based on the situation. And I quote, courage was not always a matter of yes or no. Sometimes it came in degrees, like the cold. Sometimes you were very brave up to a point, and then beyond that point, you were not so brave. In certain situations, you could do incredible things. You could advance toward enemy fire. But in other situations, which were not nearly so bad, you had trouble keeping your eyes open. Sometimes, like that night in the ship field, the difference between courage and cowardice was something small and stupid. And the final one I want to share comes a couple of pages later. I like to end with this one because it brings the reader around the idea that this is a war story, but that people don't want to hear the real war story or the bad things that happened in war. So, quote, a good war story, he thought, but it was not a war for war stories, nor for talk of valor, and nobody in town wanted to know about the terrible stink. They wanted good intentions and good deeds, but the town was not to blame. Not really. End quote. Now you contrast Norman Bowker's story with the story told in the poem, The Charge of the Light Brigade. The charge of the Light Brigade is all about bravery and valor, and the great feats of these men who ultimately died because someone in charge made a mistake. It is the story that we, those who don't go to war, want to hear about war. It's all cannons and thunder and these brave 600 who are doomed to die, but charge right in there anyway. Into the valley of death and the mouth of hell. The charge to be remembered by us, those who still live. And the last thing that Tennyson says is what? Quote, "When can their glory fade? Oh, the wild charge they made. All the world wondered. Honor the charge they made. Honor the Light Brigade. Noble 600. I always like to think that if any of those 600 survived, his story would have been closer to the story Norman Bowker can't tell. We, the survivors, the Normans' fathers, and the Sedley Kramers of the world, are the ones that don't want to know gory details or how those details affect those who survive the battles. So, that's all I've got, guys and gals. Your assignment includes a couple of questions over specific happenings in the chapter, then a couple of interpretation questions, 3 and 4, followed by the tone of the poem and figurative language questions after the poem here. Tone, figurative language. Next, a question about the author's views on soldiers and how they are treated. That's 3. Then finally, a couple of questions about themes. What are the themes of these two pieces? What is each work trying to teach us about war and soldiers or bravery or valor? Consider those things when you're working. Email your teachers with any questions you may have. Enjoy stretching your brains a bit answering these questions. And if you like any of these chapters, you should really consider reading the rest of the book. All right, I'll stop talking now. Take care, work hard. It's all almost over. Bye, everyone.